Good afternoon, guys. We're going to talk about for homework this week is what is a stock, and we're going to do some calculations. So if you look at the stock market, obviously it's tanking right now with some significant losses. So if you're doing, you expect to lose some money in this market right now, unless you're extremely lucky or extremely good and you are making money, but that may not be the case. But don't get worried about it at all, because the market right now, it's a huge, a lot of people panicking and selling. So what is a stock? Okay, this is going to introduce you to the reason companies sell stock and how investing stock can benefit the individual. In these activities below, you will calculate the gains, the costs, and the losses associated with stock purchases and ownership. So some mathematical terms that we're going to go over, we'll be thinking algebraically. So you'll work with integers in calculating the profit or loss of investments. So our first little example here, thinking algebraically, calculate the gain or loss for each stock and record your answer in the third column, which would be a change in price. In the fourth column, write whether the change of price is a gain or a loss. And you're going to do that with a plus or minus. Plus for a gain, minus for a loss. So you bought the price at $36 and you sold it at $37.01. And if you get out your calculators, okay, I could do it on my phone. So $37.01 minus $36.13 equals at an 88 cent change in price. So this is right here, you get a 0.88, and it's going to be a gain, so you're going to write a plus. So all you're doing is getting the difference from these two. Okay, we'll do the second one. So 1242 and 1227. Already I know this is going to be a loss, so when you sell it, okay, the price difference, 1242, 14. And it's a loss, so you'd write a minus. Okay? So go ahead and go through these. All you're doing is getting the answer from these numbers, writing that number here, and writing a plus or a minus in this. If it's a positive, you gain money. It's a negative, you lost money. So how do you know when the change in price is a gain or a loss? Well, if you sold it for more than you bought it, it's a gain. If you sold it and you lost money, it's a loss. Okay? So for the next one, this table down here, multiply the number of shares by the price per share to calculate the total cost of shares. Example: 500 shares times 22.40 at per share is going to cost you $11,200. Okay, so it already gives you the first one. Easy peasy. Lemon squeezy. All right, that's your total cost of shares. So let's go to the next one. All you're doing is multiplying the number of shares by the price per share and writing it here. All right, so let's go down here. Oh, I love this word. Enrichment. All right, so for the number of shares, price per share equals the cost of shares. Find the following: 90 shares at $45 per share. Okay, so what's that going to be? So you're going to take 90, multiply it by 45, and that's what you're going to get. So what's 90 times 45? Oh, I forgot the calculator. 90 times 45 equals 4,050. Okay, so you're going to do the next one, and you're going to do the next one. I'm just giving you examples. All right, put that bold. There you go, or italics. That looks fancy. Oh, 50, not 59. All right, so what you want to do is find the cost of A, B, C above here, including the commission, okay? To calculate the 2% commission, use the formula. The cost of shares, which was 4,450, the first one. And then you're going to multiply it by 0.2. And it's going to multiply it, you're going to change the 2% to a decimal, it's 0.02. So you're going to multiply that together, and then you're going to get the total cost of the commission. Okay? Do we get that? So let's do it out. Cost of shares times 0.02. Cost of shares, I'm going to multiply by 0.02 equals 81 is the answer. So what's the total cost, though? You're not done. You have to add 81, okay, to 4,050, and you're going to get what? So what's 81 plus 4,050? It's 4,131. That is your answer. Put it in bold. All right, so that's all it is. It's pretty simple. It's a lot of math. It's applicable. Go ahead. If you have questions, I've created a Google chat. If you want instant answers, all right, or you can email me either way. But the chat is not for, group chat is not to go around and say, hey, what are you doing? What are you doing? This is for school. It's for questions pertaining to school and the work. You guys have other avenues to message each other, okay? Slap face or what have you. So that's what you can do. All right. See you on the flip side.